Welcome to Gamereactor Live. Today we're going to take a look at World of Warcraft. I have been staying off this quack thingy for about a year or two. Rasmus?
I'm still playing it. Yeah, I'm still playing it.
Yeah. And we're going to basically take a look at some of the new stuff and be a bit nostalgic about some of the old stuff as well. And take it away.
So, first decision, I guess, is which character do we want to play with? Because I got my... We can get it on screen? Maybe? No? There we go.
We will be following the chat, hopefully, when I get an iPad. Am I getting an iPad? Cool. So if you've got anything you would like to see, just write it in the chat.
Yep.
And we'll try to fulfill that wish.
If we seem stressed out, it's because we've been dealing with technical issues all afternoon.
Oh,
like
yes.
Like the last minute thing that
you got it working 10 minutes ago or something like that.
Yeah, pretty much. So.
Yeah.
So anyway, Warlock or Druid is the big question.
I think I would like to see the Warlock just to see... What happened with the pits and stuff like that? You've got a strange blob there.
The Warlock is my... He used to be my main character. I've been playing this guy since just before the Burning Crusade came out. But sometime during Pandaria, I felt like, I want to level my Druid. I had a Druid alt that was level 50-something.
Yeah.
And I've been maining with him, like, pretty much ever since. So my Druid is actually better geared than my Warlock, even though the Druid is technically my alt. So anyway.
I know that feeling. I think I haven't played World of Warcraft since... I've played it on and off, but when I was playing full-time, so to speak, I think the Felguard was the new pet in town.
Yep.
And that was around Burning Crusade,
That was Burning Crusade, the Felguard was added. This guy is a... I'm running a destruction spec, which means no Felguard for me. This guy is the Beholder, which I have because I have, the Grimoire of Supremacy, which replaces all your demons with more Observer. Sorry, my bad. Replaces all your demons with more Asking demons. It's better demons. So that's what the Felpup looks like. This is the Imp, I think. Yeah, that's the Imp.
Can we go a little closer on the guy?
Yeah, probably can.
Yeah, like that. Now we've got the Pandarians.
Yep, pandas.
Not sure what to think about those, but...
I think they actually look okay. Yeah, they're cool. They're fair. They're nice.
I think it was the whole bad press thing, you know. Oh, it's going to be a kids' game now. Just pandas and stuff like
Kung
that.
Kung Fu Panda.
But I think they pulled it off quite well.
Yeah, also, the monk, I've only leveled my monk to like level 15, so I haven't played a lot, but my friends who are playing monks say he's awesome. So anyway, what are we going to do?
Well, I have... Oh, you're at Golden Terrace. I always loved all the PvP...
Battlegrounds,
yeah. I didn't really like arenas. Basically, because whenever I was sitting down, I just wanted to relax and not be that focused. I always ended up being extremely focused anyway.
Sure.
But it's just that feeling, you know, I can just sit down, relax, hey, I'll just jump into Aelstrek Valley or something like that. And I ended up being totally absorbed by it. Battlegrounds could be fun.
Yeah. Let's see.
What are we up to now? I mean, I remember Wintergrasp and Aelstrek Valley, Strand of the Ancients, Isle of Conquest.
There are many battlegrounds now.
So new stuff like the Battle for Gilneas, Temple of Komogu. Well, pick anything. What have you played those a lot or are you not into battlegrounds at all?
I haven't really touched battlegrounds since Cataclysm, I think. So this should prove interesting. And last time I did, I just did Aelstrek Valley because I realized I needed, like, a couple of inches of rep for some title that I wanted or whatever. So we might as well.
Of course, we could be old school, take a look at Altec Valley. I doubt that there's very much old school about it.
Could
anymore,
just do a like bonus. There's bonus battlegrounds. Join battle. Random battlegrounds. There we go.
They're going for random.
Yeah, or Silver Shield. Oh, that's one of the new ones. That has a bonus. We'll join that.
Go for that.
Right? No? What's it saying? Oh, I must select at least one row. Right. I'm DPS.
In case anyone is wondering why we're moving a bit slower at times, it's because we're sitting, 4 meters from the TV?
Yeah.
So it's a bit kinda tough to see. Actually see what we're doing. It's not the optimal distance to play WoW in.
Look at my magnificent flying carpet.
Someone is asking, what are your eye level?
My eye level, yes, that's a good question.
But this one wasn't your main anymore.
No, this guy is my main anymore. This guy is, let's see. Eye level 505? Yeah, 505. And I think my druid is like 525. I only raid LFR, looking for raid, because I have like 4 friends who play WoW.
Oh yeah.
We have a little guild for ourselves and then we just do LFR raids. So I think I'll max. The highest
and item
level
yeah.
I can realistically get is like 528. If I want to get higher than that, I need to do like normal mode raid or flex mode raid or hardcore raid. So that's that. 505 on this guy, 520 something on the druid.
How about flying just a bit around instead of waiting here?
Yeah.
Just let us take a look at environments, stuff like that.
Hey, keyboard trapped out. Nice. Oh, there we go. Keyboard works again. The joys of wireless hardware.
Oh, yes.
So this is the Veil of Eternal Blossoms, which was completely desecrated last patch. Like, this used to be like a beautiful flowery area. There used to be a lake over here.
Yeah.
That's all gone for story reasons.
And there's a Chinese dragon.
That's a great big dragon. I don't know why it's here or what it does because you can't hit it. It's just there. And my keyboard died again. That's cool.
Are we going to grab something else? Maybe a USB keyboard and an extender?
I don't think we have a cable that's long enough. Got the tech guys on it. New batteries, thank you. Thank you. Ah, shit. This is AAA, it uses AA. Or other way around.
Blanco is writing, I'm actually not that familiar with WoW since I'm a console gamer, but I was always interested in the series. Maybe I should start playing it.
Yes, you should. Well,
say goodbye to your life then. I mean, it's going to take you over. That's at least what happened for me. And the reason I don't play it anymore is basically because for me, it's I can't play it and only play like an hour or two a day.
Right.
Because it starts to feel like I don't get the rewards, I don't know anyone.
Sure.
And so for me, it's something like I need to play it 8 hours a day to actually enjoy it.
Yeah.
So I would rather not.
I have 75 days played on this guy.
Yeah.
And that's since shortly before the Burning Crusade, so that's like, how many years was that? 7 years or something?
Yeah.
8 years maybe? So that's not too bad.
I realized I had about 2.5 years played. And that's an insane amount in, I think, 7 years. So that's basically a third of my life gone to this. But I don't regret it. I mean, it was great fun, and you met a lot of people also in real life that went to quite a lot of actually parties and stuff like that with people, and you're going like, you know, meeting a huge fat guy and going like, hi, who are you? Oh, well, I'm the gnome warlock. Ah, that's you. Woohoo.
Of course.
So that was a bit fun.
Yeah.
Where are we now?
This is Valley of the Four Winds. which is like a farmland.
And that's part of the new...
That's part of Pandaria. We're in Pandaria.
Okay. Yeah.
Pandaria. Over here at Half Hill Market is my farm, because you get a farm in Pandaria.
Maybe we should actually go through whenever you're... after the next battleground here. Mm-hmm. Maybe go through the old Azeroth, take a look there, and,
sure.
and just jump through, you know, to Burning Crusade and see what happened there, and Battle of the Lich King. Just take a tour to all the, basically, all the expansion and games.
We could do that.
In case anyone is interested in seeing that, of course.
Okay, I have absolutely no clue what's going to be happening here. So this will be fun.
Someone's writing, I can't wait for World of Dawn, or WoW today is kind of broken in my opinion. Running around with so much HP is just far-fetched. And I kind of agree with that, but then again, I think since day one we've heard that WoW is broken. So,
Well, I get what he means. I mean,
Yeah, exactly.
I have how much HP I can't even see from here, but I have like 460 something, I think. Yeah, 460,000 HP right now.
Yeah, that's crazy.
That's kind of ridiculous.
Yeah, I remember being a tank and having, what, 22,000?
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, whoa, insane.
Yeah.
And now it's just...
my Chaos Bolt crit for like 210,000-ish damage, so...
Yeah, okay, they definitely need to change that. It's getting ridiculous.
That's coming.
Yeah.
With Draenor. The item squish. So we'll be back to like 20, 30. Yeah. 1,000 HP.
Oh, and you're doing the jumping thing.
Oh yeah. That's a funny story actually, or I don't know if it's a funny story. It's a story. Back when they were running early alpha on WoW,
yeah,
didn't have jumping. You couldn't jump.
Oh.
And players got bored. So they added jumping to alleviate all the waiting around, and that's why it's there. Like whenever you're waiting for. The last guy to show up for a group or whatever.
You can jump.
You can jump around.
Well, I'm quite sure I wouldn't have played WoW as much if I couldn't jump. It's an integral part of WoW.
Oh, here we go.
So, and it's first time you are in this?
First time ever. Background. And I just realized that I haven't installed Deadly Boss mods. So if there's any like PvE elements in this map, it'll be interesting.
Did you buff people? I have no idea if you can
I got a buff. Yeah, no, the Warlock has
changed everything.
Has a stamina spell damage buff. No, stamina intellect buff, which is neat. Oh, enemies. Destroy them.
So how many mods are installed here? Any at all?
None at all.
So this is how the interface looks today
yeah.
without anything. Okay.
And I'm dead. Cool.
Release spirit.
Oh yeah, that's right. Don't just wait around for a rest here. I think we're losing. Oh, no, now we're winning. Cool. Oh, it's right. It's the minecart map. Cool.
So how come you don't like battlegrounds?
It's not that I don't like them, it's just I've spent my time elsewhere. I am getting my ass kicked. I did play a bunch of Alterac Valley back in the day. Not as much as you did, but...
I don't think anyone did that. I would buy Altric Valley if it was a separate game, standalone game.
Sure.
And with nothing else but some gear and stuff like that from there. I will enjoy that. I think I once joined an Altric Valley, and that must have been when I was Horde. And we're up at the bridge. I don't know if anyone knows Altric Valley, but it's basically a long stretch. And in the bottom, you've got the Horde camp. And in the top, you've got the Alliance camp. And basically, you need to nuke the bosses up or down there to win. It was a bit more complicated in the old days, and you had a lot of going back and forth. But you had sort of that bottleneck at the bridge. Close to Alliance, and I remember joining a game, and they were up at the bridge, and I'm asking, well, fucking hell, because I see all these kills from the different people, and I'm saying, okay, how long have you been playing this? Oh, we've been playing it for 8 hours.
All right, cool.
So yeah. One battleground, 8 hours, and I said, well. We're at the top, and I'm going to get some kills, and we're going to have some fun, and we are close to winning this, so I will stay. And I stayed, and it lasted 13 hours more. So 21 hours of Altric Valley. And I remember, you know, joining at nighttime, and in the morning, people came in again, and they were going like, what the hell? Is this the same battleground that I left yesterday? And we're like, yeah, welcome back. But we won. And that was the important thing.
I am getting completely destroyed by Rogue right now.
But it was crazy fun. I remember having, I think, about 1,200 kills or something like that of Battleground, and that was insane.
I think my first Altric Valley took 3 hours or something.
Oh, yeah. Now, of course,
nowadays it takes 20 minutes or something.
Yeah. And I definitely miss the old days. I get why so many people were complaining about it, but I was there to have fun and not to, you know, get some fast honor points.
Sure.
So I really liked, you know, that it took a long time, and you're spending time getting the towers and doing the different stuff there and getting the mines. Now it's basically just circ the headquarters and get it over with, because we need to queue for another one so we can get our gear. And well, of course that's the motivational factor in World of Warcraft. It's always to get the next piece of gear.
I can't see a goddamn thing. Is this the healer dude? I think that's the healer dude.
That's definitely not the optimal way to play this. Seeing they're trying to see the screen, and it's like, can I?
This guy just won't die.
Someone's asking, which of those expansions are must? Well, you need them.
Well, I mean, if you buy World of Warcraft now, you get everything except Pandaria.
Yeah. So it's not really a matter of choosing anymore. But then again, you couldn't play Path of the Lich King without having Burning Crusade on that. So
yeah, but
it doesn't matter anymore.
It's all part of the battle chain.
You buy the full game with all the expansions except Pandaria. Mm-hmm. So you can jump right in. And actually, they've got the whole trial thing, where you actually don't even have to install the full game. You can they basically stream some of the world.
Yeah.
And you play that and try it. And I think it's free to play till level 20 or something like that.
Something like that, yeah.
And if you want to get the full game after that, you pay for it. So it's a good way to get a feeling for it. It's an awesome game. For me, it had that great mixture of you know, do I want to do something really adrenal intensive today, or do I just want to fool around? And I think there's not a lot of games that does this as well. So if you just want to sit and relax and have a cup of coffee, do nothing, look at the screen, and you can do that. And if you decide, and I mean, today it's even easier if you decide to go raid and stuff like that, because you don't need to be in a huge guild or have all these things prepared.
Just raiding has never been more accessible than it is now.
Exactly. Basically just queue up and you're good to go. Of course you need to have a certain level of gear to join, as far as I know. Right?
Yeah, but I mean, if you start doing heroic instances, you'll gear up enough for the lowest level raid, and then that'll give you gear for next tier of raids and then next tier.
Maybe you could explain a bit about heroic instances. If people haven't tried WoW at all. And
An instance is usually what, when people say instance, they refer to the five-man dungeons, which are like, the dungeons where you go and fight bosses.
And you typically have a setup of a couple of DPS and
that's
damage per second, the guys nuking stuff. Yeah.
Guys doing damage, a healer healing, and a tank getting beat up.
Yeah.
And then you get better gear doing that than you'll get outside, usually, just running around the open world and questing. And so at some point, you're skilled enough and geared well enough that you can raise the difficulty to heroic, which is harder.
Could you ask them to keep down?
But also, get you even better gear. Better loot, better equipment. And then at one point you'll begin. But actually with the last patch, they opened something called the Timeless Isle, which is a new zone with a sort of PvP, world PvP focus, but also a bunch of loot drops. And that'll basically gear you up for...
So you're getting loot drops from mobs?
From mobs and from quests and from chests.
Is that where there was, I think, some talk of an auction house there where Horde and Alliance could sell to each other and people were basically camping and nuking each other?
No, I think that's somewhere else. I haven't used it, but I think that's in the old Pandaria world. But the Timeless Isle will get you good enough gear that you can start doing Siege of Akramai, which is the last raid in the game, the final raid. Cool. I don't even know what I'm hitting here. Oh, there was a guy there, cool.
Yeah, someone is writing. I remember in the old days in vanilla, TBZN, Wrath of the Lich King, before they implemented like queuing for random instances and battlegrounds, the social was much more fun because you needed to find people to go in an instance and you made friends with them. Now you just queue a random one and finish it without saying a single word.
Yep.
I definitely agree on that.
There's some truth to that, but also I think...
At the same time,
Yeah, I mean, if you've ever stood around trying to find people to do some goddamn instance that nobody was interested in...
Then it's a godsend.
Yeah, it's a godsend. And also because, you know, so on the old low-pop servers, low-population servers that didn't have a lot of people on them, you were basically screwed. With the raid, the Dungeon Finder, the tool you use now to find group members, where it all happens automatically, you just... It picks from a pool of people across servers. So, you know, your server is basically empty, you'll still find people to do your thing with. Firelock, goddamn. You probably are, aren't I? And it's the same with the Raid Finder. I mean, just the fact that playing on your own, you can still get to see pretty much all the game and kill Garrosh at the end, or beat him up at least. You couldn't do that in vanilla, you couldn't do it in Burning Crusade, I don't think you could even probably do it in Wrath of the Lich King until very, very late on.
And then again, I mean, you get better gear if you actually take the time to
absolutely
be social and build up a guild and do stuff like that. So I think they've hit kind of a good middle ground.
And I mean, back in the day when I was raiding proper with the guild, we did we were a sort of casual guild, meaning we didn't raid a lot, which translates into Alliance 1, goddammit. How bad did I suck? Not too bad. or players worse than me. Cool. We were a casual guild, which translated into three raids a week at 3.5 hours length each. And that's, I mean, that's a lot of time to dedicate. I was just a student back then, so I could. But like now, I wouldn't even dream of spending that much time on a game in that sort of organized fashion.
Yeah,
because
yeah,
it really eats up your evenings.
I mean, I was on a PvP server that was pretty insane. I remember having the second highest rank at that time, and basically to try and keep that rank, I was aiming for I think High Warlord it was called back then, and I played about 14 hours a day to keep up on this. When the results came in after a week, I lost rank. And that's when I decided, okay, if I'm playing 14 hours a day, basically doing nothing else, and my girlfriend is starting to hate me, maybe I should cut back. So that's what I did.
You did multi-boxing and everything as well, didn't you?
Again? Yeah, multi-boxing. Oh, yeah. In case anyone is wondering what that is, multi-boxing is basically you set up so you can play with more than one character at the same time. And you do a lot of macros and stuff like that, so you're actually able to control several characters. I had the easiest ones to play like this was ranged characters. So of course I had three shamans, three warlords, warlocks, and three hunters.
Sure.
And then I was multi-boxing some of the instances alone. It was definitely doable with three shamans, and that was a lot of fun. I remember having actually also because I ended up in the beginning, I decided okay, I'm going to twink. Mm-hmm. Some of my characters, in case anyone is wondering what that is. It means basically enchant your gear, make sure that you have better gear, much better gear due to enchants that would normally be possible on that character level. Mm-hmm. So I did three level 19 hunters and went to the battleground and played all three at the same time. And they were called Tic Tac and Took. And someone was asking at the time and saying, "Wow, you guys play really well together. Do you play a lot?" yes, I do.
There's a guy on this server called Pink Skull.
Yeah.
Who multi-boxes. And I think he has... I think the most people I've seen him with were like 25 characters, I think.
That's insane.
Like 23 Death Knights and then one Resto Druid and a Warlock.
He
usually hangs around here or the terrace we were at before, like just standing around flexing. If he's not out on the Timeless Isle kicking ass.
So in case anyone is wondering what this is.
This is Orgrimmar.
This is Orgrimmar redesigned.
Yeah, they did that for Cataclysm.
Yeah, it looks amazing and now it's actually...
There's actually been a couple of changes. Yeah, there's been a couple of changes as well with the last patch because they've been gearing up for the Siege of Orgrimmar, the final raid of Pandaria. So. All this stuff is new. War machines, things, prisoners about to get shot because they're trolls.
In case anyone is wondering, the old WoW, while it's still 3D, they did a lot of fake 3D, so to speak. You couldn't fly over Stormwind and actually see the full layout because it wouldn't work. Mm-hmm. Some of the streets were too long compared to the buildings being there and stuff like that. So when they went for what was it?
That was Cataclysm.
That was Cataclysm. They redesigned everything. Yeah. So it's actually now proper 3D with the right dimensions.
And goddamn wireless keyboard. Oh!
Lovely.
Yeah, love it. It's working again. So yeah, now what? You want to do something? More battlegrounds?
I think we should go for a tour. See what's changed in
All right.
Azeroth. Wouldn't that be a thing? I mean, like, go to Crossroads and that was Crossroads.
Is in the Barrens.
Yeah, that's one of the smaller towns in the Barrens, and that was always a good place in the old days to start a fight. If you were alliance, you just went all, took the long trip from Stormwind and Ironforge and went there, waited outside that little village, and...
Is the cord long enough?
If you switch places...
We'll give that a shot.
We're going to switch places. We're pretty tired of a wireless keyboard not working. I need that chair because I've got an amazing back.
There we go.
Crossroads were one of the places where I went. Also, Taran Mill. If you wanted to get into some open world PvP.
And,
I remember being guild master of
Battlefield
Dirty Danes. That was a plus 18 guild, only for Danish people, of course. And we went there when basically no one had mounts yet. And we were, I think, 30 people mounted up. And we just waited in a line outside Crossroads on our mounts. And people panicked. And of course, soon they came from Alkmaar to help. And we had a huge fight and we nuked them all and it was amazing. And we got so cocky that we decided to raid Alkmaar. Mm. At that time, you had some pretty hefty guards in there. So of course we all died horribly in there, but it was great fun.
I've never raided the capitals and that's a shame.
Oh yes.
You get a mount for killing all the opposing faction bosses.
Oh yeah.
So anyway, they actually changed, because all of Azeroth changed with Cataclysm. And then there hasn't really been any significant changes to it since then. Except for the Northern Barrens, because this was sort of the setting of, in the last patch, which was gearing up for the raid on Akramar, Siege of Akramar raid. They added these Quarkron bases where you there was a quest. For every week you need to gather like 150 times four resources, 150 pieces of wood, rock, stone, oil. If you did that enough times, you'd get a title, Dark Spear Revolutionary. And you could also use it to get loot and stuff.
All right.
So I did that.
It seems the chat seems empty. I remember.
Oh yeah, Baron's chat is dead. Yes.
Oh, but that was awesome. Mm-hmm. That was definitely the worst place you could ever be for chat. The amount of rudeness and stupid comments in there.
Back
was
in the day,
legendary.
The Barrens was the second zone you'd hit as Horde player if you were a troll, or an orc, or a tauren.
Yeah,
the undead had their own on the other continent, and it was a really big zone, and you would level from like I think like 10 to 20.
Yeah, you were actually able to do that, yeah.
Yeah.
And of course you could go to a Wagefire Chasm and if you nuke the elites down there, you could actually manage to get to 19.
That meant it was a really big zone with a lot of, they've cut it in half now. Like it used to be all of this area.
Yeah.
But it's two zones now. With a lot of really grindy quests where just like kill 100 of these snout.
Grind tusks or tusks or snout tusks, yeah.
And a lot of people were new, didn't really understand the game, so there was a lot of stupid questions in the parents' chat.
I think Manquick's wife, that was one of the questions that always came up.
Yeah, it's a quest line where you're helping this orc out, helping him revenge his wife, who's been killed by these big dudes.
So now there's water here.
Oh yeah.
And that definitely...
Yeah, this used to be dry and a gulch. We can head down to 1,000 Needles.
Oh yes, I heard that. It's one of the places that changed quite a lot.
That used to be a
dusty.
We should almost do that on the druid because I've been questing down there with him. Which means I had the boat, because you get a boat for 1,000 Needles because there's so much water there. Where's the flight point? it's up here, is it? Where's the flight point? Where is the flight point?
Apart from this, I mean, Pandaria seems to have changed a lot of stuff. And which expansion did you actually enjoy
the
most?
That's a good question. Oh, there's the flight path. I'd say probably.
Let me see.
Wrath, maybe? Wrath of the Lich King?
Oh, yes.
I was raiding actively in the Burning Crusade, so it should probably be that one, maybe. But as for the actual leveling and the questing, Wrath was a lot better. Cataclysm wasn't as good as Wrath. Pandaria has been really good, I think.
I agree. I enjoyed Wrath of the Lich King quite a lot. I think they've changed so many mechanics, and you had quests that didn't feel like, hey, go kill 10 boars, come back. And of course you had that whole epic quest line happening in Orgrimmar and the Undead.
The Wrathgate thing?
I've forgotten. What is the Undead City?
Undercity.
Undercity, of course, yeah. What is the Undead City? but you had that whole quest line, and I think that was epic.
There's a quest, a really long quest line in Wrath of the Lich King that ends up with a couple of really cool cutscenes where everybody dies, pretty much. And then you go lay siege to Undercity and basically take it back.
Yeah, and basically game turns into an instance.
Yeah.
So with a couple of other players also doing that part of the questline, if there's anyone.
Yeah,
if you're
grouped with anyone, they would be with you. Well, that was it. Then it was just you and Thrall, the Org leader at that time, and
you could actually be joined in Undercity even if you weren't in a group. But
really?
Yeah, they would just show up.
Really?
Yeah. Because I remember doing that and being like, who the hell are you?
I did it with a friend.
But anyways, it was I really enjoyed that that expansion. I was playing a lot solo at that time.
Yeah.
So I didn't really, you know, care much about instances and so on. I like doing the quests.
Why can't I remember what the undead faction leader is called?
Anyone in the chat?
Yeah, seriously, help me out here.
Just state the question again, I think.
Yeah, undead faction leader. It's not Tyrant Whisperwind. She's a night elf. What's she called? God damn it. Oh well.
Someone was saying, for how long do you guys think we will see WoW expansions?
A
couple of years?
Yeah, at least one more after this one.
Yeah.
Probably two more after this one. Wouldn't be surprised if they did that.
And then it must be time to move on. Oh, well, not move on, but I'm quite certain that Blizzard is looking for the next big MMO.
If you look at EverQuest, that's on its, last time I checked, 17th expansion.
Yeah.
It's been a while since I checked, so it's probably on its 20th by now. And I have no idea how many people are playing it, but they keep cramming out the content, so.
Exactly, and if they keep doing that, then the game could basically live on forever. They're also doing what the new character models we're getting in the next expansion makes it look a bit more fresh.
Yeah.
They definitely look cool. If you haven't seen any of those, you can actually see it on most Gamereactor websites. If you go and look at the, what is it?
Warlords of Draenor.
Yeah, Warlords of Draenor expansion. You can see some of the new models there. They've changed quite a lot. And looking at this, there was a time when I played this on a crappy laptop, and I think it never really mattered how good it looked. As long as you had a decent frame rate, you were just happy, because it's so well designed and it just gets, you know, it just gives you that feeling, your imagination runs wild. And you fill in the blank spaces, basically.
Sure.
So you don't need it to be realistic looking or amazing looking. And this still looks great. And well, I wish, of course, that they would move this to a mobile platform. because we're definitely having hardware there that could easily handle this. Even if they had to customize a keyboard for this. Mm. Or let us connect the keyboard. So I think it's got a long time. We can stay afloat. See, Sylvanas?
Sylvanas! Yes.
Someone
Sylvanas
is saying Aliera, Sylvanas, yeah.
Yes. I was thinking about, couldn't remember what the Dota class is based on her. It's called.
Someone is saying, speaking of expansions, someone is saying at least 3 or 4 more. They wrote a 5-year contract with the history writer. But then again, I mean, yeah. It doesn't necessarily mean that they're actually putting out expansions. It could just be that they are doing minor updates and stuff like that and different quest lines. But
sure.
Still.
We should do another Battleground.
Should we take a look at Altrek Valley?
Yes.
Just show people what is
Altrek Valley.
That is the my favorite battleground for whenever I feel like doing hurting other players. I definitely like Agrati Basin as well.
Mm-hmm.
Was on Gulch. I wasn't that fond of it in the old days, but it kind of grew on me.
Right.
I'm not too happy about, I think it's Strand of the Ancients and stuff like that. I didn't really enjoy that.
I haven't touched anything more recent than Eye of the Storm.
No, Eye of the Storm, well,
so
it was actually decent, but, well. Anyways, Altrek Valley, we are in queue for that one.
Yep.
And that is the one that has been, you could say, nerfed or streamlined.
Yeah.
So nowadays you take about 20 minutes to do that. The longest one I had was 21 hours. I only stayed for the last 13 hours.
That's incredible.
Yeah, I think the normal time for that one was about 4 hours in the old days. And but it could go wrong and you could stay there forever. So. Someone's saying, as long as an efficient amount of people still play by the game, it can, in theory, go on forever. Oh, yes.
Exactly.
And someone's saying, although, you know, that 5-year contract could be for Titan, or whatever it's going to be called. Who knows?
Calls me for other Warcraft.
Is the looking, I'm guessing LFR is looking for weight.
Yes.
Is the looking for weight as horrible as they say?
It can be very testing on your patience. Particularly in Siege of Orgrimmar, the latest raid, because that one is actually pretty hard. To the point where a lot of people have no idea what's going on. The raids that before that in Pandaria are a bit easier. They're not as mechanically demanding.
Mm.
But for instance, there's 4 wings to Siege of Orgrimmar. The end boss of the second wing is General Nazgrim, who you've been questing with both in Cataclysm and here. So that's like a huge story moment that you get to fight him and kill him because he's actually a decent dude. He's a warrior, like warrior class warrior, which means he changes stances throughout the fight. So he starts out in a normal battle stance. Then he goes into a berserker stance where he takes extra damage, so you want everybody nuking him there. And then he goes into a defensive stance where whenever you hit him, whenever anybody but the tanks hit him, he builds up rage.
Oh.
And whenever he gets a certain amount of rage, he spawns adds. So
and basically,
so when half your rage is idiot DPS players who are just looking at all the pretty numbers they're making and nothing else, you'll get a lot of adds.
Oh.
And they'll yes. Some of them are healers, some of them are like rogue assassins that'll sneak up on you and backstab people. And still, every time I play that boss, I need to like shout at people, stop DPSing the boss in defensive stance, go on ads.
Yeah.
And then even, you know, most people get it when you shout it at them, but you still see a couple of hunter pets just biting. and a lot of the later, pretty much all the fights outside the first wing are have some mechanical demands that you need to know what to do. You need to know when to stack, or you need to know that you got to have a group, a little group, go attack that tower, or then attack this tower, so you can bring down the dragon up above you and fight that. And if people don't know that, you'll wipe, and you'll wipe, and you'll wipe again, and again, and again. Yes. So that's fun. but I mean, I did the last one yesterday. That went pretty well. We only had one wipe, I think, and that was on Garrosh. Because the range didn't know that they had to kill a dude that spawned a thing that kills you. Which is, you only need like three people to handle him, but they couldn't. They didn't know that.
I'm still
had to be told.
I'm still surprised, you know, whenever doing a raid or something like that, how few people actually listen or actually read the chat. I mean, even, and it goes way back, I mean, even to Molten Core.
Oh, yeah.
And you would be there and you would say, okay, we need to skin these freaking dogs. Mm-hmm. And every time it would be, loot the dogs, someone loot them, come on. Of course, everything is easier today, and you can set loot in different ways. And,
sure.
But I mean, you had so many times where you're like, do we need to say this every time? And we did.
We could go do Molten Core.
Oh, we could solo that.
We can solo Molten Core. Should we solo Molten Core? Is that what we want to do? Guys in chat, tell us.
Are we going to solo Molten Core? That would be a bit like soloing Dead Mines, I think, today. If you look at how much gear you have and the HP stats.
A friend of mine, the guy I played the most WoW with, he started in vanilla with hardcore raiding back then. And I didn't jump on until Burning Crusade. So we've been sort of backtracking, just me and him, going through all the raids that he used to do and then all the raids I missed and then up to up through Burning Crusade. So we've been soloing Molten Core and Onyxia and Ankiraj, which I hate because, man, the mechanics on that one sucks. All the way out to Black Temple so far, which is fun. Also, just to get, like, loot for transmogrifying. It was a shield that drops from Illidan that he really, really wanted for his warrior. And there's an item. He's trying to forge a particular hammer or something, a mace, that you need a legendary drop from Ragnaros, the boss of Molten Core 4. The first time he went there, it dropped, and I got it. And it's bind on pickup, so I just sold it. And he hadn't decided at the time that he wanted to make that mace, so just, you take it. Like, yay, gold. And since then, I think for a while now,
I can see where this
for a couple of weeks, he hasn't been going, but he's been going there pretty regularly. Like every time the cooldown was done, he'd been going there. It hasn't dropped since.
Oh my God.
So he's cleared that place like 100 times now? Oh, not 100, but like 20, 30, 40 times maybe. 30 times at least.
Someone's saying, like, is this WOD?
Oh, Warlords of Draenor. No,
of course. No. All these separations. So.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, it's not. No. We are simply just taking a nostalgic stroll through World of Warcraft. And we are at the same time looking a bit at some of the changes that has happened. We're doing this without any add-ons or any mods. So we're basically just showing what the interface looks like today. And how it is to be in WoW today without you having to, you know, stop living your life and,
Nice.
And now Rasmus is absorbed in looking at...
Yeah, this guy's wearing, they're just looking at the transmogrify. Mm. Because that's the, I think, tier one druid shoulder skin. Something like that.
So transmogrify is basically, apart from being the Calvin and Hobbes term, it means that you can
take an item and then you can make it look like another item that you own.
Oh,
so if you have that's also why you've been doing all raids, you know, just to get the
so
the armor
sets. If I went to Dead Mines and got some of the Van Cleef stuff there, you know, like the black stuff, you could actually put your high level gear stats on that one.
It has to be like the same armor type.
So leather and leather.
Leather and leather, and plate. Yeah, and like swords and swords. You can't make a sword into a mace, but
yeah.
other than that.
Okay, cool.
Yay, Alterac Valley.
That is something I would like. Oh, it resets idiot. So, oh yes, awesome. Now we're back. Yeah. And this is Alterac Valley, and can you, well, you can go and follow and take a quick look at the map.
Follow this guy.
And hope that he actually knows where he's going.
No, can't follow.
Okay,
can't follow. Well, okay, the idea is, this is like a PvP battleground, but you're fighting PvE bosses.
Take a quick look at the map, just.
So all the way up here, there's an end boss. There's some towers and stuff along the way. If you bring those down, you kill off some of his reinforcements and stuff. So you're trying to kill him. The other team is trying to kill your guy down
in
your base.
That
down yeah, here.
Of course.
And then some people should probably try to defend, but that won't be me today.
And when they just changed this, there was a time where actually it was quite popular to stand in the cave and do nothing.
Yep.
Because you would still get an amount of honor for that. And I actually remember having a game, and that was pretty fun. I think it's 20 versus 20. This one is still, what?
40 versus 40.
40, okay. And I think we were about 6 people actually playing. and that was a bit insane.
Beautiful.
And of course, it didn't help to report anyone, and you would just see them pop up next battle again. So that was horrible, and of course they sort of tried to change a bit of that by making it shorter. But in the old days, you could, for example, summon a giant elemental here. I don't think that's ever happening anymore because no one cares, no one has the time. But you could get a lot of, I think it was Druid standing there, summon this elemental dude that would smash everything in the opposite faction, and that was pretty cool. Stuff like that was fun. And this has always been a popular spot for people thinking Alterac Valley is about getting kills.
Yeah.
So they would ride in there and they would just nuke each other. In here there's
a mini boss.
A mini boss that should. I'm not quite sure if they changed it, but should change your resources and resources and stuff like that.
Yeah, something about sure. Yeah. I think we're. Are we skipping that? Apparently, we're skipping that. No, she's dead. Okay, cool. I think she's dead.
Yeah, we're looking too long at the map and stuff, doing stuff like that. There's also a couple of quest lines in here. There's also a couple of quests like finding the 3 dudes from Top Gun, or what is it? Goose and
Maverick.
And
Iceman.
Iceman, yeah. And of course, these are the Griffin Masters here, but it's still a reference to Top Gun anyways.
So do we have this tower? Apparently we don't.
Come on, go do Molten Core instead of AV. Well, we're definitely getting there, so don't worry. I mean, we've got almost 2 hours. We are, as you might know, streaming every day, every weekday live from 1600 the Central European time to 1800.
So we do. So
we've got 2 hours today, and I'm quite sure we can manage that in the last hour to go to Molten Core.
This is kind of embarrassing. I can't even remember how this works. I don't know if we have this tower. I don't think we have this tower. Do we have this tower?
Isn't it you need to touch that gray?
But this has a horde sign, so I guess that's already happened, maybe.
I don't. And then it's counting down.
Why didn't I install deadly boss mods? Oh well. Just a bunch of dudes. I think we're taking the tower, is what's happening. So we'll hang out here and then.
Well, it used to be a timer in the middle, but
yeah. That's what I'm wondering too.
And we're sitting here not having any mods installed. I actually used to play almost without any mods, apart from waiting.
I got a lot of mods.
But I prefer the clean, not the clean, but the normal UI.
I don't mess much with the basic interface, but I have a different cast bar when I'm playing at home. Mm. And I have a damage meter, of course, healing meter. And I have Gatherer for finding stuff, farming, which is like a large, it's an overlay on the map with a database of every plant or mine or whatever you want.
So as you can see on the map, people are already up there trying to
We'll go help him in a second once this thing catches fire.
It's a timer. Just run. Someone is saying. So, go.
All right. All right.
What is the green circle in the top just under the ally? 40 points.
Green circle? Huh?
What?
That's a real guy. That's a, dude.
Cool. I'll be right back.
Aw. Nasty business. One of the major changes to PvP in Pandaria is the fact that I think resilience, or no, not resilience, but there's like a lot of innate PvP stats you just get for joining a battleground or joining an arena, which is also why my Chaos Bolt, which usually does like 200,000 damage, only does 50 on a player. Really looking forward to that squish with Warlords of Draenor. So up here is the bridge, and there's a graveyard here that we should be conquering. I don't know why we aren't, because that's where the Alliance players who are defending up here will spawn. But many, many hundreds, if not thousands of people have died on this bridge trying to attack and defend the enemy. I'm in combat. Because I'm a geek, I've made a macro for when I mount up that randomly selects one of the many, many mounts I have. Because I'm a geek. That's how I roll. In here is the final boss, which I really should have deadly boss mods for, but we'll manage. Standing over there. This dude, yeah. These are his guards. I think the more towers you bring down on the way up here, the less guards he'll have with him. So that tower's fallen, that tower's fallen, so he only has two. These will fall in a minute, so he'll lose these two guys as well. Reinforcements up here on top is like the amount of respawns you have. Wait, oh, did it end? Oh, we lost, okay. So yeah, that's a pretty common occurrence. The Alliance guys killed our boss. So it's over, we're done. Oh, leave battleground. Oh well. That's what we get for noobing it up. So, we are going to Molten Core, which is over here. So I just gotta figure out the fastest way to get there. I guess that's Sevelin to Stranglethorn, which means we're going to Akramar. And there's a faster way of going to Akramar than just flying. We lost our battleground.
Oh no.
Yes.
And it took, what, 10 minutes?
Yeah, something like that.
Baltic Valley?
Yeah. Something that used to take, that could once upon a time, could take 20 hours. I'm sure part of it is because they nerfed it, but I guess part of why it's so much faster now is also because people figured out how to win it.
But they also removed a lot of stuff.
They did? All right.
So basically now it's just forget everything else. It's not important. I mean, They should just have kept it that way. So if you didn't nuke the mini boss, he would have a lot more and harder ads.
Sure, but I think that's still there.
But I think they haven't really followed the gear advancement. So they're being too easy now. So you can just basically ignore them and go like, yeah, I don't care.
But no, I think you still need.
We're
heading for Molten Core. Is that the Zeblin? Oh, that's the Undercity Zeblin. Okay, cool.
So if you're watching this stream, you should comment in the chat. No matter what you want to say, if you're interested in getting 2 months of free game time for World of Warcraft.
Oh, we have gifts.
Yes.
Ah.
I just got an email from Blizzard saying,
nice.
Hey, we're watching, go nuts. So, hi guys. basically, if you haven't played for a while or if you want to get into it, here's your chance to get 2 months of prepaid time for World of Warcraft. So we're going to draw a winner between all the comments in the chat, and we'll announce it at the end of the stream.
That is effing sweet.
If you win, stay in the chat, or send me a private message. And I haven't actually introduced us at all. I'm Lee West, and this is Rasmus Lund-Hansen.
Well, at this point, everybody knows us.
Yeah.
We're counting on that.
Also known as Abacus, that's me at least, and Tic Tac Took, oh. Kick, Red Hand. Damn, I've had many characters in
Warcraft. I've never been good at names. So this guy's named Barstow, named after a city in California, which, because at the time I was making the character, I was like looking around my room. What am I going to call this guy? There's my copy of Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas, which opens with the line, "We were somewhere around Barstow on the edge of the desert when the drugs began to take hold." So, yeah, Barstow. I'll name him for that. My druid is named Mubaka.
Mubaka.
Yeah. I wanted to name him Mufasa, but that was taken.
Oh.
So, Mubaka was...
But Mubaka is more fun.
Yeah. At the time I named him, according to the armory, I checked. There was like 2 other Mubakas.
Mm.
Now there's 50.
Ah.
So I did it before it was cool.
I've never been to that silly name, so well, apart from Tic Tac Took or Tic Tac something.